That's not a dugout. That is a dugout. This massive catamaran is called the Iosepa, which means Joseph, so I'm very fond of this boat for more than one reason. The thing that makes this tremendously cool is that this is a replica constructed in the early 2000s here at BYU Hawaii to demonstrate the type of boat construction that you see in the movie Moana. So this was used to sail all the way to Tahiti and back, and ones like it, similar reconstructions, have been used to circumnavigate the planet. A 3-year voyage completed last year actually managed with a whole bunch of rotating crews, they would rotate crews in about every month, were able to use traditional navigation techniques to go all the way around the world with this level of technology. Everything about this fascinates me. The construction fascinates me, the way that it was used fascinates me, the ship itself fascinates me. I love everything about this because this represents the ability of people using hand and eye to circumnavigate the globe. It's about awareness. It's about being so in tune with where you are that you're able to find your way. The whole concept of wayfinding is tremendously cool. With modern instrumentation, it's a little bit like flip the switch, you know where you are. GPS satellites basically take care of that. The Polynesian islands are so widely distributed in such a massive ocean that you really need to know what you're doing to get to them in the first place. And New Zealand actually is the last large landmass on the planet that was ever settled, as far as we can tell. The South Pacific is kind of the last frontier. These are the last places that humans came to settle permanently. And so the history here is really young. And the level of sophistication to get here in the first place, the bottlenecks that you have to get through in order to get people onto this place is that you have to be able to find tiny, itty-bitty little islands in the middle of the world's largest ocean with limited food supplies, limited water supplies, and waves that are trying to kill you. So the achievement is staggering. Using only hand and eye and an acute awareness of the sun and the stars and swell patterns. When a wave hits, a swell hits an island, it will reflect back. It's like when you make ripples, and after the ripple hits the edge of the pond, it will start to reflect back. And if you are very, very sensitive to this, you can see these ripple patterns and start to detect if there is an island and what direction it's coming from, or what direction it is relative to you. So, amazingly cool thing. Most genetic evidence, following things like the genetics of the pigs that they have, and the genetics of the people, and the genetics of the coconut trees, all point to an origin of the Southeast Islanders in Taiwan and in China, and then migrating down through the sea this way. But there is a little bit of evidence that the contact reached all the way to the Americas and started to go a little bit this way. And that is sweet potatoes. Sweet potatoes have the name Kumar in Quechua. And that is tremendously cool. That's in Peru and Ecuador. That's Incan-speaking areas. And in New Zealand, in Maori, the word for purple sweet potato is Kumara. It's almost the same word, it's genetically the same plant, and it's one of those very few New World plants that could be found in an area that's kind of technically the Old World. That's because before Columbus, these guys had made it all the way to the west coast of America. That's incredible. That's yet another link in the global chain. I'm just gonna geek out a little bit about a few more things about this ship, and then someday, I would like to ride it. I don't know how well you can tell, but these braces, these beams that are holding the two sides of the catamaran together, are actually laminate construction, meaning these are multiple pieces of wood that have been glued together. Basically, this is like a really high-end bow, like the Asiatic horn bow, where you have different materials being glued together to get the best of their properties. And the reason for that is because you don't want a fully rigid construction. You don't want these to be rigidly stuck together. You want them to be able to flex just the right amount so that they can handle the waves. This is tremendously cool. You may be noticing a trend. I think basically everything on this is ridiculously cool. Here are the lines showing the different types of wood that have all been laminated together. Gosh, that's cool. the pontoons on this catamaran are actually hollow. And if you look in here, not only is it these laminate construction up here, but you can see that this is not composed out of one tree. This has been sealed to a level that, funny enough, Captain Cook, when he came through, he said that the level of finish work that was on these canoes rivaled the finest furniture he had seen back in Europe. So glossy, glossy shine like this is completely historical. And they would seal it with various nut oils. That is tremendously cool. So hollowed out with stone tools, laminate construction, so unbelievably awesome. These little cutouts are called butterfly joints, and they're used to stop cracks. So if there's a crack running along here to reinforce it and make sure that nothing bad happens, they'll cut in an hourglass-shaped hole and then stick in an hourglass-shaped wedge, and that will hold it tight. And this is used in high-end woodwork all around the world. It's very common in Japanese woodwork. The thing that I find fascinating about this is that prior to European contact, this type of woodwork was being done with stone. Get that, stone tools. It blows my mind that they were doing this with stone tools. So you can think of stone tools as primitive. I mean, we've done a little bit with stone and bone tools before in trying out hollowing a dugout. Not as nice of a dugout as this one, but the quality of craftsmanship that the people were able to bring through those tools is mind-blowing. So anyway, lots of mind-blowing happening around here. This is the Iosepa. It's amazingly cool. If you're interested in how this thing was used, check out the Polynesian Voyaging Society. We'll leave a link at the website here. And yeah, if you enjoyed this video, please hit the like button and subscribe below.